Hi, welcome back to Web Visions 2010. We're hitting the home stretch. We've just got a few talks and a few hours left. But right now, during the break, I'm joined by Scott Farad of Cheeseburger Network.
Hello, thank you.
Okay, I will admit to being a great lover of the cats, of the cheeseburgers and the little cats. How did it go from, oh, look, it's a cute little picture of a kitty, to an entire network of insanity?
That's a great question. So to make a long story short, it all started when a guy named Eric had his girlfriend Carrie send him a picture of a cat saying, ICANN has cheeseburger. Mm-hmm. And Eric was a web developer. Mm-hmm. And he said, that's funny, I'm gonna put that on a website. And he started doing that. He put one on a website and he started collecting up some more because he thought they were funny and cute. Mm-hmm. And things like that. And it got to be a lot of work. And a friend of Eric's named Ben, Eric didn't want to do it anymore, so a friend of Eric's named Ben, mm-hmm, said, well, I'll do that for you, I'll take that over. And Ben saw that it was more than just cats, it was actually humor. And so the whole idea was, okay, let's take cats and then do dogs. And after we did dogs, we did celebrities. And then after
Where's
we did celebrities.
Walrus? We need to talk about the bucket.
The Lolrus. I love the Lolrus.
Yeah, he's my favorite.
He's my favorite too.
Nice.
Yeah, there were some people in New York who made an off-Broadway play basically modeled off of The Wizard of Oz, mm-hmm, about the cat and the Lolrus and a few other characters all going through the world trying to find their thing. The Lolrus was trying to find his bucket, mm-hmm, and the cat was trying to find a cheeseburger. Mm-hmm. And of course they got to Oz or whatever the land was in the play and found it.
Yeah, very nice. So what are you doing here at Web Visions? You're speaking in like 10 minutes. Mm-hmm. What are you talking about?
I'm talking about some of the ways that we sort of operated the company and built the sites on all of them. I've done
the
a lot
technical
of,
end of it?
More the technical end of it, or at least say, the technical and procedural end of it. Mm-hmm. I've done 6 startups, mm-hmm, and we did Cheeseburger very differently. Mm-hmm. We sort of said all the ways that we did these other startups before, we were going to do the opposite this time around.
What was that?
Because it wasn't as much fun before.
Okay.
It always seemed like there was a tension between, I'll just say, business people and product development people. Mm-hmm. And so we tried to make some changes and do things differently so that it wouldn't be that way.
You want it to be more of a group effort? Everyone happy all together?
Well, in part of a group effort, but in part it was a group effort. Mm-hmm. But in part it was to say, well, what are the specific things that is causing this tension?
Yeah.
And how can we change the way we do business to eliminate them? And part of that was really being able to kind of let go of some things and accept some other things. So for instance, one thing we had to let go of was being perfect. And
it's hard for people to let go of.
Yeah, and so you've been to our sites. Uh-huh. They're not the most beautifully designed sites in the world.
They're effective though.
But they're effective. So we had to let go of some things like, is the navigation perfect or is the layout perfect or whatever, so that we could make progress. Mm-hmm. We had to let go of having really strong, tight schedules, mm-hmm, because one of the big pieces of contention is a schedule, you know, one person has the schedule they want in their mind, and then reality is something totally different.
Correct.
And it just creates this really tension.
But some people cannot work without a schedule.
I wouldn't say that we would have no schedules, but we didn't try and plan things 6 months in advance.
Okay.
We said, what's the next thing we're gonna do? What's the next project? And we'd, mm-hmm, schedule out that project and finish it. And wouldn't spend a lot of time worrying about 5 or 6 projects down the road.
How many sites are part of the network?
I just looked this morning, we have 52 sites.
52 sites.
We do, we try and launch a site a week.
Uh-huh. So a site a week per year at this point?
Practically speaking, it works out to about two to three a month. Mm-hmm. And some sites don't succeed, and so we shut them down. Our mode of operation really is, what's the least expensive, easiest way that we can get one up and going, uh-huh, to see if people like it, if they find it's funny, and if it makes them happy. And if it does, then it keeps going. If it doesn't, we shut it down, or we take it and we revision it a little bit and adjust it and tweak it a little bit.
How long do you wait to see if it's working?
It varies from site to site. I'd say some, you know, 2-3 months,
yeah,
kind of.
When you're not CTOing the Cheeseburger Network, what are you doing?
Oh, that's a great question. Well, I live in Seattle. Mm-hmm. I have a family. I have 2 kids. Mm-hmm. To make a long story short, we swim in the summer and ski in the winter.
That's the nice thing about the Pacific Northwest. That's what you get to do.
It is. And then my 2 other personal interests, I'm totally addicted to golf. Mm-hmm. And I'm a huge fan of live music. For a little while, I tried to write a music blog, and I stopped that. I just didn't have the time or the patience to do it, but I love it.
Are you a musician?
I am a little bit of a musician, a casual musician, but not in a...
Not in a serious sort of way. I'm going to grow up and be a musician kind of musician.
I conned my wife into marrying me by telling her that I was going to be a musician, and then I, you know, didn't happen. And but no, not that I'm going to grow up and be a professional musician.
All right, well, I'm going to let you get to your talk because I know you need to get there, and they probably want to mic you up, and they'll probably hunt me down if I don't get you over there soon. But it was really good to talk to you, Scott.
Thank you, and thanks for being a fan of our sites.
Yeah, they're fantastic.
All right, take care.
Thank you.